Hello, my dear children and parents. Welcome to class 7th of Indus Valley Public School, Rat, where we will be studying lesson number 4 from your English Honeycomb. Name of the lesson is The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom, written by William Elliott Griffiths. So, my dear children, this is a lesson about a good couple with a good heart and a couple with a cruel heart. And we will be learning about a moral that good deeds never go in vain. That means if we are doing good to anyone without any expectation, then we will be rewarded in any form. That means we should never ever do anything wrong or that may hurt anyone, any creature, any human being, including animals. So we should not do anything that will hurt anyone. And always try to do good for others. So the moral that we will be learning in the story is good deeds always rewarded and evil deeds will be punished. Okay, children? So now, we will be studying about the author. The name of the author is William Elliott Griffiths. He was born on September 17, 1843, Philadelphia, PA, was an American Orientalist, Congregationalist minister, lecturer, and prolific creative author. He did his education from Rutgers University, Union College, and Union Theological Seminary. In September 1817, Griffiths was invited to Japan by Matsudaira Sangaku for the purpose of organizing school along modern lines. In 1871, he was superintendent of education in the province of Echizen. In 1926, Griffiths was invited to return to Japan, and on this trip, the Japanese government conferred a second decoration, that is honor. He was presented with the Order of Rising Sun, gold rays with neck ribbon, which represent the third highest of 8th class. A private rail car was provided by the Japanese government. Griffiths was a founding member of the National Institute of Art and Letters, later to become the American Academy of Arts and Letters, the American Historical Association, and the U.S. Naval Institute. He died at his winter from a home in Florida on February 5, 1928. So, this is about a writer. The name of the writer is William Elliott Griffiths. Okay, my dear children, this is all about the author. Here, the main character in this story are old good couple. There is a pet dog whose name was Muko, and old wicked couple, they were the neighbors. Okay, so these things we will be studying in this lesson. So now moving to the lesson. So children, here is your lesson 4. So before we start reading the lesson, let's begin. This is a story about an honest and hard-working old couple and their pet dog. The neighbors are troublesome and the dog dies a sad death. The spirit of the dog gives solace and support to his master in unexpected ways. So this is what here it is told, that there was an honest and hardworking couple, that is good couple, and they had a pet dog. Okay, And they had a neighbor. They were very troublesome. Means they were creating problems to them. They were not good. And the dog died because of them only, and that to a very sad death. Then the spirit of the dog, okay, the spirit of the dog helped his master in a very unexpected way. Means nobody was expecting that how this dog's spirit is going to help their master. Okay, so this we will be seeing how dog's spirit helped his master. Okay, so now the ashes that made trees bloom. So in the good days, good old days of Demio, there lived an old couple whose only pet was a little dog. So there was a couple in the Japan, we used to say there was an old couple and they were not having any children and they lived with a pet dog. Having no children, they loved it as though it were a baby. So they were loving that dog as their own baby. The old dame made it a cushion of blue crepe, and at mealtime Muko, for that was its name, would sit on it as snug as any cat. So old dame means old lady. Okay, dame means and very elderly, or you can a mature woman, the dame means. Okay, so then that old lady, she made a cushion of a blue crepe. That means cushion, I think everybody know, it's a type of very soft sitting place. Okay, a soft chair, you can say. That cushion was of blue color, and in the meal time, so whenever any eating time was there, Muko, the name of the dog, he will sit very quietly, very nicely, very comfortably on that place, on that chair, like any cat used to sit. No, वो अपने एकदम घुस के बैठ जाना. That way, this dog used to sit on that this cushion. The kind people feed the pet with tidbits of fish from their own chopstick and all the boiled rice it wanted. So they used to feed the dog through their own chopstick and through their own hand, whatever the dog want to eat. If it's a pieces of the fish, they will give the pieces of the fish. Even if they want the, if even if the dog want the rice, they will serve the rice also. Okay, thus created the dumb creature loved its protector like a being with a soul. So now they used to love like anything. So this dumb creature means dog cannot express their feeling. No, they are quiet. Okay, we cannot understand what he is saying. So it is mentioned as a dumb creature, and he used to serve them like anything, like a baby. So being with a soul means like a human child showing the emotions. Okay, जैसे एक माँ अपने बच्चे को इमोशंस प्यार करती है, वैसे ही वो लोग भी उसको प्यार करते थे. नेक्स्ट, द ओल्ड मैन बीइंग द राइस फार्मर वेंट डेली विद हो और स्पेड इन टू द फील्ड्स वर्किंग हार्ड फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग अंटिल ओ टेंटो सामा. ओ टेंटो सामा मीन्स सन. ओके, हैड गॉन डाउन बिहाइंड द हिल्स. सो दिस ओल्ड मैन वॉज अ राइस फार्मर. ही हैड द फील्ड ऑफ राइस. So he used to work very hard in the field from morning till that evening when the sun goes behind the hill. That means evening time. Okay. Every day the dog followed him to work, never once harming the white heron that walked in the footsteps of the old man to pick up the worms. So what happened? This dog used to follow every day his master. And he never used to harm any creature. Heron is a bird. I think swan, this is the lambi gardan hoti, that is a bird. So this bird used to pick the worm from the ground. They never used to harm any creature. They simply go to their field. For the old fellow was patient and kind to everything that had life, and often turned up a sword on purpose to give food to the birds. So now this is the character defined for the old man. What are the characters defined for the old man? कि दिस ओल्ड फेलो वॉज वेरी पेशेंट एंड काइंड, मतलब बहुत शांत और दयालु था. एंड ही विल नेवर एवर ट्रबल एनी पर्सन, ही विल नेवर ट्रबल एनी क्रिएचर, नेवर गिव एनी हार्म टू एनी क्रिएचर. एंड वॉट ही यूज टू डू, ही विल डग अ ग्राउंड एंड ही विल पुट सम फूड इन दैट सो दैट दे कैन हैव इट वेन एवर दे फील हंगर. सो देयर विल बी ground will be dug out and he will keep some grain so then bird can come and have their meal. Who will do all this thing? The old good man. So next line, next paragraph. One day the dog came running to him, putting his paws against his legs and motioning with his head to some spot behind. So what happened? One day this dog came running towards this old man because and he was continuously scratching the body of the old man as if he wanted to tell something very important to him. And he was moving here and there, continuously moving here and there with his head to some spot behind. He wanted to tell something to the old man. The old man at first thought his pet was only playing and did not mind it. So what happened? So this old man thought the way this dog is doing to him, the dog is behaving to him, is like that the dog want to play with him. He is in a jolly mood, he is in a very good mood, he want to play. But let's see what happened. But the dog kept on whining and running to and fro for some minutes. But what happened? This dog continuously moving here and there, front and back, continuously moving around the man for some minutes. Then the old man followed the dog a few yards to a place where animal began to lively scratching. So what happened? Now, after some time, the old man went along with the dog. And what happened? What the dog did? He took him to a place and he started scratching that ground from his paw. Scratching means khodne laga pair se. Okay? What do you mean by scratching? When digging the ground from his paw. Thinking it was possibly a buried bone or bit of fish, the old man stuck his hoe in the earth when, lo, a pile of gold gleamed before him. So what happened when he was digging, when the dog was digging the field from his paw, then this old man thought it might be a piece of bone or it might be a piece of fish that the dog want. But what happened? He helped him out. For helping him, he is also dig from his hoe. Hoe means axe. ठीक है? तो a sharp type का material होता है, उसे वो खोदना शुरू किया किसने? Old man ने. But what happened to his surprise when he start digging that? What he found? He found that there was a pile of gold gleam before him. A heap of gold was there. A huge amount of gold was there. See here. He is digging. This is hoe. Okay? Kulhadi type ki jo hoti, that is hoe. Okay? Thus, in an hour, the old couple were made rich. So, within an hour, this old couple become rich. The good soul bought a piece of land, made a feast for their friend and gave plentifully to their poor neighbors. So now what this good couple did? What they bought? They first bought a land. What they bought? A piece of land. And they have given good feast to their friends. Means good meals to their friends. And even they have given money to the needy people, to whosoever living in their neighborhood. As for dog, they petted him till they nearby smothered him with kindness. So what happened? They showed their love. They showed the affection. And they covered the dog like anything. And they showed their kindness to the dog. Now in the same village, there lived a wicked old man and his wife. Not a bit sensitive and kind. So in the same village, there was a very cruel, covetous couple, was very wicked and never used to think for anything. They are very senseless and very unkind fellow. who had always kicked and scolded all dogs whenever any passed their house. So what they used to do, they used to kick all the dogs, they used to scold all the dogs, they used to kick and scold the dogs whosoever passed nearby their house. But hearing of their neighbor's good luck, they coaxed the dog into their garden and set before him bits of fish and other dainties, hoping he would find treasure for them. So now what happened? What they did? They started, when they heard about the goodwill of the good couple, so they, what they did? They started to call, they persuaded, they enticed, or they attracted, or they greedily called the dog and showed their love, and they offered him the pieces of the fish, and they called the dog to their garden, and they also gave many tasty dishes to the dog. Why they did? Because they were greedy. They want this dog should also show them the place where they can have the treasure, where they can have the amount, they can get the money or gold. But the dog, being afraid of the cruel pair, would neither eat nor move. Because every time this dog was scolded, hated by this couple, so he was afraid. And then when this couple called them to their garden, this dog did not eat a single piece of fish or any of the item, because he was very much scared, or he was scared to eat or scared to move from that place. So who was scared? Dog was scared. Why he was scared? Because always this couple used to hit them, they used to scold them, but now they are calling them in a loving manner. Then they dragged him out of the doors, taking a spade and hoe with them. So now see the cruelty of this old man. See the cruelty of this old couple, what they are doing. Now this dog was not doing anything. Now what they started to do? They dragged, they pulled in a very rough manner the dog, and they carried a spade and a hoe with them. No sooner had the dog got a pine tree growing in the garden, then he began to paw and scratch the ground as if a mighty treasure lay beneath. So now they dragged the dog. Soon this dog found out a pine tree and started scratching as if he is going to tell them about a treasure. तो वो उसको scratch करने लगा ताकि उन्हें ऐसा feel हो कि हो सकता है इस जगह पे कुछ खजाना छुपा हो. Quick, wife, hand me the spade and hoe. So now old fellow, old person, old man is saying to his wife, quick, just give me that spade, give me that hoe. Cried the greedy old fool, and he danced with joy. So now he was dancing with the joy as if he is going to get some treasure. Then the covetous old fellow with a spade and the old crone. So now covetous means greedy, and old crone is a cruel, ugly woman. So what happened? These two fellow with their hoe, they began to dig that particular place. But what happened? Let's see. But there was nothing but a dead kitten. कुछ नहीं मिला उन्हें, एक मरी हुई बिल्ली का बच्चा मिला. What they found? बिल्ली का बच्चा. And the smell of which made them drop their tools and shut their noses. So that dead kitten was giving a very foul smell, very bad smell. So they just put up a cloth on their nose and they ran away from that place, throwing everything. Furious at dog, the old man kicked and beat him to the death. See the cruelty, how they did. If they were not able to get the treasure, they started beating the dog very badly. They beat it and they kicked the dog, and these all things resulted the death for the dog. This was the sad death given to the dog by this cruel couple. And the old woman finished the work by nearby chopping off his head with the sharp hoe. So now that dog was end, that dog was dead. But this cruel lady, what she did? She chopped the head of that dog and ended his life. They then flung him into the hole and heaped the earth over his carcass. Now they dig the earth, put the dead body of that dog inside that earth, and put the mud over his dead body. Sarkas means dead body. The owner of the dog heard of the death of his pet and mourning for him as if he had been his own child, went at night under the pine tree. So now the owner, the master of that dog, was very sad. He was crying after hearing the death of his dog, and he was so sad as if he has lost his own child. And he went under that pine tree every night. He set up some bamboo tubes in the ground, such as are used before tombs, in which he put fresh flowers. So now, over his graveyard, he made a tomb, and he used to put fresh flowers in that. Then he laid a cup of water and a tray of food on the grave and burned several costly sticks of incense. So what happened now, what he is doing, he used to put the cup of water and the dishes, and he burned the agarbatti jo hoti hai na, that is. So costly sticks of incense. He mourned a great while over his pet, calling him many dear names as if he were alive. So what happened? He was very much sad. He was showing his sadness by calling with different lovable names of the pet. जैसे कोई डियर अपना ख़त्म हो जाता है तो कई अलग अलग नाम से बच्चे को बुलाया जाता है ना, मेरा प्यारा, मेरा शोनू, मेरा मोनू, मेरा टोनू, मेरा बच्चा, मेरा लल्ला, एंड ऑल दिस थिंग वी यूज टू कॉल टू अ लवेबल चाइल्ड, नो? सो सिमिलरली दिस मैन वॉज टेलिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट लवेबल नेम्स टू द डॉग, ओके, एज इफ ही वॉज अलाइव. दैट नाइट द स्पिरिट ऑफ द डॉग अपीयर्ड टू हिम इन अ ड्रीम एंड सेट, cut down the pine tree on my grave and make from it a mortar for your rice pastry and a mill for your bean sauce. Now what happened? So now he was dead. Now in that night, so spirit of the dog appeared to the dream of his master, to the good man. Spirit means atma. Okay? A pious soul. So now what he's saying to the master, that cut down the pine tree. So that where his graveyard, where his grave was there, so pine tree was there. So now dog is asking to cut that pine tree. Okay, and what he is asking to make? To make a mortar for your rice pastry. So what happened? This fellow used to make rice pastry. So for making that pastry, they need a big bowl. So dog is saying that cut my tree and make a big bowl of it in order to make the rice pastry and mill for your bean sauce. So they used to make sauce from their beans. See, this is the pine tree, this is a grave. See how the tomb is made, no? Jo kinare kinare pipes laga di gayi hai uski graveyard banane ke liye. Okay, so this is there. So the old man chopped down the tree and cut out of the middle of the trunk a section about 2 feet long. So what happened? This man chopped down the tree and in between he made a section. Beech mein se usne kaata aur usse 2 feet long bowl banane ke liye. With great labor, partly by fire, partly by chisel, he scraped out a hollow space as big as a small bowl. So a lot many hard work was done in order to give the shape of a small bowl. He then made a long handled hammer of wood, such as is used for pounding rice. Now he made a long stick, that means pounding, to crush the rice. Jaisa mein chamcha hota hai na, that way he made it a thing. Okay, क्रशिंग, जैसे चावल को घुमाएंगे ना हम उसको पीसने के लिए, दैट वे ही मेड अ बिग स्टिक, चमचा टाइप्स का, चम्मच जो होता बड़ा वाला, दैट वे. व्हेन न्यू ईयर्स टाइम ड्रू नियर, ही विश्ड टू मेक सम राइस पेस्ट्री. व्हेन द राइस वॉज ऑल बॉइल्ड, ग्रानी पुट इट इन टू द मॉर्टर. द ओल्ड मैन लिफ्टेड हिज हैमर टू पाउंड द मास into doubt, and the blows fell heavy and fast till the pastry was all ready for baking. So now this was the process to make the pastry. What they did, they boiled their rice and they started to crush that rice. Then Granny put into the mortar. Granny means the old lady. She put the boiled rice in that bowl and the old man lifted. जैसे वो आपका होता है ना वो ओखली एंड जो उसमें कूटते हैं ना दैट थिंग ओखली वाला थिंग होता है आपका बाउल होता है ऊपर से मम्मा डंडे होते हैं वो हैवी डंडा जो होता है उसको कूटते हैं तो सिमिलर दैट थिंग वॉज द हैमर उस तरह से बोलेंगे ओखली वाला सिस्टम दैट इज़ योर सो वॉट डिड दे पुट द राइस एंड दिस ओल्ड मैन स्टार्टेड बीटिंग दैट ऑल राइस सो दैट इट वॉज क्रशिंग दैट राइस एंड आफ्टर क्रशिंग उसने उसको काफ़ी जैसे एक दाव जैसे आटा नहीं गूथा जाता है दैट वे दे डाउ मीन दैट ओनली गूथा हुआ आटा तो दे हैव ऑल्सो आटे को बहुत अच्छे से उन्होंने बाउंड कर लिया बाइंड कर दिया एंड द बाउल फेल हैवी एंड फास्ट टिल द पेस्ट्री वॉज ऑलरेडी फॉर बेकिंग तो बहुत अच्छे से डाउ बन गया एंड द थिंग इज रेडी टू मेक द पेस्ट्री सडनली द होल मास टर्न इन टू अ हीप ऑफ गोल्ड कॉइन्स नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड All of sudden, the dough, that old material, converted into a heap of gold. Heap means a huge amount of gold. बहुत ऊंचाई है जो एक जगह collection हो जाता है ना चीजों का that way. Okay, heap of rice. काफी ऊंचाई तक gold coins चले गए. When the old woman took the hand mill and filling it with beans, began to grind the gold. Dropped like rain. So what happened when this old lady she lifted the dough and she wanted to grind. इनको टुकड़े में बैये जैसे बेक करी बिस्किट होती है ना वो बनाने के लिए उन्होंने डालना शुरू किया. So what happened? What they found? This whole gold. It was falling like as if it was a rain of gold coins. इस तरह से चीजें गिरने लगी. Meanwhile, the envious neighbor heaped in at the window. When the boiled beans were being ground. So now what happened? This lady, that jealous neighbor. Jealous means jo neighbor the wahan pe jo jal rahe the. Cunning neighbor, you can say very greedy neighbor. They peeped in that window. So they were peeping. Peeping means to look from a small place. So they were peeping from that window. Puri window khuli nahi thi. Bas thodi si window khol ke. They were looking at them when this boiled बीन्स जो थे वो ग्राउंड पे गिर रहे थे गुडी मी क्राइड द ओल्ड हैग एंड शी सॉ ईच ड्रिपिंग ऑफ सॉस टर्निंग इनटू येलो गोल्ड अंटिल इन अ फ्यू मिनट्स द टब अंडर द मिल वॉज फुल ऑफ शाइनिंग मास ऑफ गोल्ड सो नाउ व्हाट सेड है What these fellow were doing, they were shouting like anything, a goody, they were saying, my goodness, my God, what is happening? See, the rainfall of gold is happening. And they saw that tub was full of gold. It was shining like anything. So the old couple were rich again. Now this old couple, they became rich. And who good couple? The good couple, they became rich again. The next day, the stingy and the wicked neighbor came and borrowed the mortar and magic mill. So now what happened? This wicked couple, they came to the good couple house and they borrowed the mortar and the magic mill. They filled one with boiled rice and other with beans. So same process they also did. Ek mein unhone beans rakha, ek mein unhone boiled rice rakha. Then the old man began to pound and the woman to ground. Same thing, that's the good old man was pound. So this fellow also did the standard pound and the woman started to grind. But at the first blow and turn, the pastry and sauce turned into foul mass of warm. So what they, when they started, their all thing were turned into bad smell and there were small worms. Chote chote se kide aa gaye usme. Still more angry at this, they chopped the mill into pieces to use as firewood. So now they were angry like anything. They chopped down the mill. Whatever they borrowed, usko na chop kar diya, chote chote tukde kar diye. And what they did, they used the chopped bowl and chopped thing टू बर्न एज अ फायरवुड, जो उसने लेके आए थे उनके ऐसा सामान उसको उन्होंने काटा, टुकड़े टुकड़े कर दिया और उसको आग जलाने के लिए यूज करने लगे. सी द विकेडनेस ऑफ दिस फेलो, वेरी पैथेटिक. माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, हियर वी एंड विद द फर्स्ट पार्ट. सेकेंड पार्ट वी विल बी डूइंग इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. Meanwhile, some questions are there that you will be doing. So, first question is, why did the neighbors kill the dog? You will find out the answer and send to me. Second question, here three options are given. You have to take the most correct option, okay? So, mark the right item. The old farmer and his wife loved the dog. This is the question and the option is, because it helped them in their day-to-day work as if it was their own baby, as they were kind to all living beings. Second question, when the old couple became rich, they gave the dog better food, invited their greedy neighbors to a feast, lived comfortably and were generous towards their poor neighbor. The greedy couple borrowed the mill and the mortar to make rice pastry and bean sauce, magic ash to win reward, a pile of gold. So, my dear children, this is your homework. Please do it. Find out the answer. Go through the video and write down about author. Okay? And read the chapter. If any doubt, please do call me up and clear your doubts immediately. Do not heap your doubts. Okay? So, bye-bye. Take care and study for your examination. All the best. Bye. Thank you so much.